October is National Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and for us women, it's always important to talk about our breast health. Joining me today is Dr. Kimberly Hutcherson, Director of Breast Imaging and Intervention at Gwinnett Medical Center in Atlanta. Doctor, today we're going to focus on breast biopsies, specifically how newer technologies are helping advance and improve this critical process in the battle against breast cancer. We are so glad you're here today.
Thank you.
I want to get right to it and just start with the basics and explain what a biopsy is.
Well, when a breast abnormality or breast lump is detected, a biopsy may be recommended. A biopsy is basically the removal of breast tissue for pathologic examination. That biopsy is performed to determine if that area of concern is a benign or malignant process. There are two main types of biopsy options.
Right.
The one that we're going to concentrate on today is the most preferred method, which is minimally invasive breast biopsies.
See, all of a sudden, biopsy scared me, but now you're saying there's a way to do it that's minimally invasive. I love hearing that.
Very much true. So in my breast center, we basically try to find an environment or supply an environment that's very calming, relaxing, spa-like. They're listening to mood music and low lights and all of that. But when I perform the procedure, I really try to make sure it's very painless. Lots of lidocaine numbing medication to ensure they feel no discomfort during the procedure. Very small skin incision, about a quarter of an inch in size. We place the needle using the imaging guidance, whichever modality that I choose, whether it be ultrasound, mammogram, or breast MRI. The needle is placed inside the breast and we take the tissue that way. There is an easy transition of the tissue into a collection chamber for pathologic examination. No stitches are needed to close that particular wound or little opening.
Can I walk out with a Band-Aid?
Band-Aid, little small adhesive bandage going along about your normal activity pretty much throughout the day.
And how is it decided that a biopsy is needed?
Well, it's really based on that imaging characteristics, whichever modality that I'm utilizing, whether it be a mammogram, an ultrasound, or breast MRI. And so, when you initially present to a breast center, you're going to usually present with a mammogram.
Mm-hmm.
We may find areas of concern on there, which we call calcifications.
Right.
Sometimes we see little round white areas, which may be masses, so we have to do a dedicated breast ultrasound to clarify what that particular area is. It could be a benign cyst. Could be something that's more suspicious that has irregular margins or the location of that may be inside of that cyst, a solid mass, or inside of a duct. So that may indicate a biopsy is recommended.
But we shouldn't be scared, because I think sometimes when women feel a lump, they get really nervous, but a lot of times it's not bad news.
This is very true. The majority of these lumps or palpable areas are actually benign, but as we know, patients present in extreme opposite fashion. Some may be really frightened and go to the extreme that they have breast cancer, while others may be less attentive and not take advantage of the initial evaluation of mammogram and ultrasound. And so it's really important to notify your referring physician's office so we can see you at the nearest breast center, evaluate you with diagnostic mammogram and ultrasound. And remember, majority of these are completely negative or benign.
And that's such good news.
Very
and you're
good
a
news.
Survivor of breast
I am
cancer.
A survivor of breast
and
cancer.
And been performing a minimal invasive biopsy for 14 years now?
Exactly, 14 years in practice.
Tell me about
that. In my practice, I have chosen to do minimally invasive breast biopsies as a diagnostic radiologist and breast interventional radiologist. I choose to use a device that really allows me to get the maximum amount or quality of tissue that I like to form that I know that I'm getting a diagnostic accurate biopsy. And I use a vacuum-assisted breast biopsy device.
Okay.
The particular system that I use is a mammotome breast biopsy system. And I like the particular system because it is an easy system for me to use for my staff as well as the other physicians who may join my practice. And I have quality tissue samples that really provides me with the diagnostic accuracy that I need and really minimizing the time, the cost, and morbidity. That's the main thing. It's really kind of letting women know their choices, empowering them to have education about their options. When you have this possibility of having a biopsy, I know it's a fearful process, but you really want to have those options available for you. Know what your risk and benefits for this procedure is, and then talk about these options with the referring physician so you choose the best option for you.
You're such an inspiration. You're a survivor yourself.
Yes, I am. Thank
you. You're taking women into your office. You're giving us a spa-like atmosphere, and
yes,
you're saving lives.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us
today.
Thank
you for having me.
For more information on the World Wide Web, visit mammotome.com. That's mammotome.com or breastbiopsy.com. And, of course, you can get social with us on Facebook at Balancing Act Fans. Share your personal thoughts related to today's very important topic.